What's up, everyone? I kind of like this setup better. We moved stuff around in my room, and yeah, so I think it looks nicer for a background, at least this way. I only have one light in here, and it's a ceiling light, so if it's a little bit shadowy and creepy, I'm sorry. I'll try to brighten it up. I just wanted to quickly update anyone who watches my channel about my pregnancy. As you can tell, I'm pregnant, and you know, I'm pregnant, obviously. I am 23 weeks today, exactly 23 weeks today, well, that I know of. I keep getting told every time I go to see my OB that I'm further along. I could be a little bit over 23 weeks, but probably not more than 24 weeks, I'd say, because I've already been told twice that I was further along. I'm carrying a boy. I was not expecting to have a boy. Well, I was expecting it once I got pregnant, but I was hoping before I ever got pregnant that I would have a girl. Unfortunately, it's not how it is, but I'm not too upset about it. I can tell he's gonna be very active, though. He won't stop kicking me all the time. Like, he is constantly moving. Which has been one of the better things of my pregnancy, even though it hurts sometimes because he kicks so hard. He likes to kick my bladder a lot, which is nice, because then sometimes I'll just be like, I gotta go pee right now, and just leave the room. So if you ever are one of my friends and you see me just get up and leave, where I had to pee out of nowhere, and I just went pee, it's probably because he won't stop kicking my bladder. I have this thing on. It's a belly band. It's like Velcro over. This one's actually a 3X. It's a little big or whatever, but honestly, it helps a lot. It's not really big because you can adjust it. It's just like the recommended sizes for like further along and bigger women. But this is the only one they had, and I was not gonna suffer forever and ever because he is very heavy, very, very heavy. I started really feeling the weight and strain of how heavy he was about 16 weeks in. And I'm 23 weeks now. It's even heavier now. He seems to lay this way, not this way. So I have like one stretch mark and it's like right here. And just like long ways, which is completely different than anybody I've ever seen have stretch marks. I really don't care about stretch marks. I'm, you know, obviously it comes with the game. And we've gotten clothes and crib and a lot of stuff that we need for him already. The main thing we are not prepared for is we don't have a name yet. And I don't know when we'll have a name. But it's just me and my boyfriend like different names. It's hard to decide something that we're both gonna be okay with that's also gonna match his last name, because I'm gonna give the baby his last name because we plan on getting married and all that jazz. I don't know when we'll get married, maybe. I probably will be after the baby born, I would say, for sure, because the baby's gonna be here before we know it. But I would say maybe end of this year, sometime next year, probably we'll get married. We do live on our own. I'm gonna start working as soon as I can once I'm done being pregnant, because I just hate this sedentary lifestyle I've had to live because I was so sick most of my pregnancy. Like, I feel a little bit sick right now, but it's not bad enough to where I'm gonna like lay down and do nothing all day. I actually cleaned for the first time today, and like, I know people are like, gonna be like, you cleaned and that's a, like something you're excited about. It's been, what, 23 weeks? That's like 5.5, 6 months, something like that, right? I haven't been able to clean anything because of smells, and because I can't usually see him for more than like 5 minutes, I haven't been able to clean anything for a long time. And I actually finally cleaned the sink in the bathroom because it was bothering me, because I don't like dirty bathrooms. I don't like dirtiness in general. But since I've became pregnant, it's been a little harder to keep up on stuff. And my boyfriend does pretty well about keeping up on it, but there's always one room that is like kind of messy, and that's usually the room I was in all day, just because it's hard for me to stay cleaning up after myself because I just get so sick. The main discomforts I've had is like my back is hurting right now, like right about here, And it does hurt sometimes down here, and that's usually when I put this on, and then it stops hurting. Or like if it's hurting right here, I'll usually put this on. But yeah, my back will usually hurt about my shoulder blade area. If I lay down on my back on accident, I'll wake up in pain. Because like if you lay down on your back, as you're further along, it hurts more than you would imagine it would. So you gotta try to talk yourself in your sleep out of doing that. My hips, because I can't sleep on my back anymore, they're usually fine when I'm standing up. My knees are usually what hurts when I stand. But my hips, when I sleep, are excruciating. I'll wake up in pain so badly because I slept on my hip for like an hour, and then I have to flip over and sleep on my other hip for an hour and do that back and forth all night. Other than that, I don't really wake up too much, other than maybe to go to the bathroom. I do wake up sometimes because I'm hungry, but I usually just like trick the time, and if it's close enough to the morning, I'll just wait. But other than that, my pregnancy, besides the HG, oh, I also found out I have vertigo sometimes during my pregnancy. So that was another fun thing, another reason why I shouldn't work while I'm pregnant. Is HG is excessive vomiting and nausea throughout pregnancy. It can come back and go away, come back, go away. We're gonna have it constantly. And vertigo is where you get dizzy and feel like you're gonna fall. And that's pretty much where I'm at with my pregnancy. And hope you guys like this little pregnancy update. And I'll try to do another one soon. Bye.